2016, David's year. 2017, David's year.
What are some New Year's resolutions you got going?
Well, I'm gonna learn my kids' names.
What do you think their names are?
Last week I thought it was Joe and Kristen, but their mom said it's not. It's not
so what's
Joe.
Their, what are their names?
I have it written down. No, I have Joe and Kristen written down.
Nick lost a bet, so Eli's gonna shoot him with an airsoft gun a couple times.
Nick, you gotta take your shirt off.
Are you fucking kidding
me? Take it off.
I don't know what to do.
Just pull the trigger.
I just throw the whole thing.
Nick, you are so scared.
Like, I was drunk and now I'm not.
Oh my god. Go.
Oh my god, it got you right in the belly button.
Oh, I feel so bad. I'm so sorry. I feel so bad, but I feel so good.
Let's do it again, because now you're used to the pain, right?
What do you want? How much more do you want to shoot me?
4, 3, 2.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh god, I feel so bad. I still feel so good though.
Oh my god.
Nick, we gotta do it one more time. I wasn't recording. I
swear. They literally all look like nipples. Yeah,
you're right. Oh my god, you got shot so hard here.
Oh yeah.
When you need clickbait. Oh my god, you got shot so many times.
Are you Jewish? I'm not a racist. Am I Jewish?
Yeah.
Not anymore. Oh, well, I got kicked out of the temple.
How'd you get kicked out of the temple?
I did a prank on the rabbi.
What was the prank?
I just went up there and I took my dick out.
That's not a prank. Why'd you do that?
If you film it, it's a prank.
No. Have you ever played pranks on your kids?
Sure.
What's the last prank you played on them?
I told him I was gonna be a good father.
We just drove by Todd's ex-girlfriend's place and I swear to god, this is what he does. He goes, oh, she lives right there. You wanna go spy on her? This is my favorite part about Nick. Nick, I haven't confronted you about this, but I think it's really funny. Nick's been in this thing for like 2 weeks now, right? Like about 2 weeks. And when he posts an Instagram picture with it, it does so good because people feel so bad for him. This is the best part. This is the best part. Sometimes he'll post a throwback picture to when he wasn't in it, and he has to reassure everyone that he's still in the brace. In the caption, he'll put, "Don't worry, I'm still in my brace." You know it's true.
I know it's true.
You're over here like, "Don't worry, guys, I'm still injured. Like my picture." So Zane and I have been talking, right? Let's say, for example, you died. How long would one of us go without posting a vlog? Like, how much of a break would we take after one of our deaths?
Why would you take a break?
Let's say if Heath died. Zane's saying that it would take him 2 weeks to ever post a vlog again.
I think longer than that.
You say exactly what you told me.
I'll tell you exactly what I told Zane. I would take a day off.
That's just crazy.
If Heath died, I would have a lowercase caption saying I'm gonna miss him a lot.
Hold on. So Heath is his... I'm gonna miss him a lot, and then mine is thank you for everything. What the fuck is that supposed to mean?
Mine would just be like surprising my girlfriend with a puppy.
He won't talk about your death in the video. He'll talk about it after the outro, like the, you know, after the black screen.
The last 3 seconds, it's just like, oh yeah, by the way, guys, Scott died.
If Liza died, that's when I take off a while.
You take off
like two days. If Liza died, I'd probably even quit vlogging.
But it was a job when I died. But it's not a job when Liza dies.
You are my colleague. She is my one and only.
I am just a colleague.
I feel like talking about this though is kind of foreshadowing one of our deaths.
Probably mine. If anything, I'm the one who's gonna die because the bad shit always happens to me.
So basically, if you see a lowercase caption in any of our vlogs, it's because someone died.
If you see a lowercase caption in my vlog, it's just because I've given up.
But if you see an uppercase caption, there's always a chance that Scott's died. Once Scotty dies, I have to put teardrops in my eyes.
The fucking pastor putting me in the ground, he's like,
there's too much Scotty at this funeral.
I write a book this year.
You're gonna write a book this year?
Yeah.
What are you gonna title it?
How to latch onto a 20-year-old internet star.
That's today's vlog. Thanks for watching, Jamie. Make sure you like and subscribe. Tweet me at David Dobrik. Liza and I went to Chicago this weekend and we met my parents for the first time.
He met his parents for the first time and so did I.
I didn't know I had parents. No, she met my parents for the first time and they didn't want to be on camera so I couldn't record it or anything. But she did surprise my siblings because they're really big Liza Koshy fans.
What?
In 3, 2, 1, open it!